Good evening, everyone.
Hey.
I'm actually very nervous. Okay, so inheritance. I actually picked this topic to sponsor, and I'll get to that towards the end of my story. I think inheritance is very important. I came to the United States when my mom was pregnant with me, and surprisingly enough, she took a plane, two or three planes, to get here from Haiti. And I guess they say a lot of Haitians are from Benin, which is Africa, West Coast Africa. And they say the tribe that's there is the Fulani tribe, which are traditional, they're nomadic, and they enjoy traveling. So surprisingly enough, my daytime job is I travel the world and buy art. Yeah, And after I graduated college, I didn't want to go become the traditional doctor, though all my siblings are in the medical field. And I kind of went on the lam finding myself. And I found myself going to Chicago, LA, Miami, living there for a couple months here and there, doing my whole nomadic thing. And I remember talking to my mom, and I was just like, you know, I just love traveling. She says, well, you know, you were in my stomach when we came here. And I was like, yeah, that's interesting. And when I was young, I would always remember we would go travel, we'd go to Boston to see our family, because our main family wasn't located in the New York City proper where I grew up. They were in Boston, Canada, Miami, Haiti, and we would travel. And I remember traveling a lot. And it was mainly for, you know, weddings and funerals, unfortunately. And I found it to be kind of, I mean, when you see families and you hear storytelling, it's kind of reminiscent of what we're doing here today. So, inheritance. I decided when I was about 27 that I was going to open an art gallery with Haitian art. And many say, you know, you didn't grow up there, how could you do that? I was just like, well, I've been to Haiti. My mom tells me about my culture. I know how to cook the food, and it's kind of been inbred within me. I am inherently Haitian, you know? And I find it, I speak the language, of course, and, you know, people find it so like, well, how'd you learn it? Oh, we spoke it. You know, and that's how you learn, through the traditional storytelling and speaking and the power of the tongue. So interestingly enough, I said, I'm gonna open an art gallery and tell the story of Haiti. I'm gonna spread the culture. I am going to use that as a tool to educate and empower. Subsequently, it grew into more cultures, and thus I travel all over. But the goal of the gallery was to hopefully gain some affinity for the culture and build some affinity for, well, the goal really was to build economic development and infrastructure. You know, that was my goal for Haiti. I'm like, well, how am I going to do this? And so 4 years later, still have a gallery, and now I'm like the chairman of this Haitian professional organization. And we've all come together, right? Because we're like, oh, we don't have necessarily our friends and family close to us, but if we all come together, because many of us are first generation, we could be really strong. And the one thing that ties us really closely is these stories that our parents told us, our food, our culture, that we all inherited. So I was really nervous, and I just decided I'll tell you my story and the power of inheritance and culture and how it's impacted my life and how I live it and breathe it every day. Hope you enjoyed.